Jen here, and today I have a little project to share with you. Actually, it was kind of a big project, but it is a guest design team project for Kitty Scrap Post, and I will leave the link below, but Louisa has these amazing printable kits that you can order online and just print up. They're instant. And so easy to use, and I like how versatile they are because you can kind of, use your printing preference and kind of size it to whatever your project, the size your project is, which was really cool. So yes, I will leave the link below. The collection that I use for this project is the Angelic Christmas collection, and I use the paper collection and the cutouts, but I do know that she has other things. She has like, domino size of this collection and a bunch of other ones too, so definitely check it out. I'll leave the link below, but so I'll show you what I made. What I did was I had this idea. It was going to be a banner, but then it turned into something else. So I had this idea to make a wall hanging, and what I wanted it to be is pockets. So I could just keep my my Christmas cards that I get right in here. And so these are just some of the postcards that are in the printable kit. So there's that beautiful little angel. So I figured I'd keep these in here for now. There's like this one, it's like a vintage postcard. And then there's this one with the beautiful angel and the cherub. And then I think there's one more in here. Here it is, another, so cute with the snowflakes. So I kept those in there, but that's my intention with this wall hanging is I really want it to be like super shabby because that's, this paper is like screaming shabby. And yeah, I thought it would be kind of cool just to kind of keep all your Christmas cards in there and have it a pretty hanging at the same time. So I'll start at the top and work my way down. So it's going to be a little tricky, you guys, so bear with me because it is relatively, it's pretty big. So the top part, I just have a dowel rod, and then I just attach some really pretty ribbon that I had, and then I just put some foam flowers where the ribbon attaches. I thought that was really pretty. And then just to make it really shabby, I just put some scrap fabric and lots of laces, in little knots on the dowel rod. And then I have this really pretty thick lace that I actually got from Natasha, from Natasha's Scrapbooking. Hi, Natasha! She gave this to me back in the spring with my Fairy Day Challenge, and it worked out perfect for this project. So I have that here. I have these really pretty appliques. This was actually one long applique and I cut it up. That's Annabelle saying hi. And then what I did is we'll get back into this. So I attached that to a piece of fabric. See if you can see the back. It's just some like muslin fabric. So I attached that, the muslin, and then in between is like a thicker, I think it's, what is it called? It's, I don't know, it's really heavy duty fabric, like almost like a canvas kind of, like what they use to cover a canvas. And I put that in between, and then all this top part is, it mostly got covered up, but there's like a little bit showing here. And it was just a long runner. And so that's what I used for the front part of the of the hanging is a runner. And then what I did is I took Louise's kit, and what I did was I printed it up on fabric paper. So you can see here, this was one of the pages in her kit. Isn't that so cool, you guys? And it printed up so beautifully on this, the fabric paper. You can get that at Joann's. It's like $5, so, so cheap. And you get 4 sheets in the pack. So I printed it up, and this is another page from the collection. Isn't she so pretty? So this paper is just so shabby gorgeousness. So I have that page, and then there's this bottom one, which is the same as the top. I just loved it so much, and I want it to kind of match too. So what I did is I made that the pocket, see? And so that would be your pocket to put your cards or your postcards or whatever. So that's what I did there. So that's the main part of it. So after I sewed down the pocket, I put some really pretty ribbons all around the edge and some flatback pearls at the top. So you can kind of, you know, tell that that's the top of the pocket. And I just put some really pretty lace on top of that. I have this really beautiful applique here. And this was just part of like a shirt I got at the Salvation Army, and I thought it was cool and added lots of texture. This is another part of the Angelic collection. This is a cutout. So this is actually printed up on paper. I printed him up, but he's on one of the sheets, and I just cut him out and I stuck him behind this really pretty heart doily. And I just have some, you know, lots of doilies here. Some little ones here, and I strung some pearls all around, kind of just like they were like tossed down on it. And I have some of these really pretty snowflakes here and here, just to make it like really pretty and shabby winter. And then over here, what I have is a big doily in the background, and then a little one. And then I made this really pretty shabby flower. And this was just a Gatsby flower with some different laces I had in my stash. And then I layered on 2 doilies and then this really beautiful bling. I've been hoarding these, you guys, because I don't have very many, and I don't go tag sailing that often. Just because it's tricky with all the kids. So I bought these, and I thought this was a good project for it. I have this really pretty feather, and then this is another angel from the collection. Isn't she so beautiful? I know my shirt kind of sticks out behind her, but she's part of the collection as well, so I cut her out and put her on there. And then I just have some scrap laces and stuff hanging down just to make it super shabby. These big snowflakes I got at the dollar store. I thought they were so cool, and they look awesome against the fabric, because this the tinsel like really stands out. And then the next pocket is like I showed you before. It's the same paper, but there's like a couple more little things, like the violin and this really beautiful like Victorian lady. But it matches really nice. So I printed that up and put that as the second pocket here. And in the corner here, I put a couple of rolled roses with some of the same muslin. And I have some cheesecloth here that I just toned down with some of my sprays, because you know how cheesecloth is like so, so white. So I just sprayed it a little bit and put that there, and it just gives it like a nice soft texture. You know, I have some more of the mini flatback pearls with some really beautiful lace on top of that. And then over here, this is just like a crazy cluster. There's lots of doily layering here, and I have this really beautiful applique here. I have some pearls just scattered about, and some cheesecloth on top of all of that. I have another one of those really pretty snowflakes. I'm not sure if the camera picks up how pretty it is, but I really like the way it looks with the tinsel. And then this little butterfly is also part of the cutout collection. So I just cut that little out, the little butterfly out, and I thought that was so cute. And it matches so beautifully. I have another little mother of pearl button right here. And then I made another really pretty flower. And this one, I used the tutorial that Trisha, a little shabby chic, gave on how to do this little shabby rose flower, and it was so fun to make, so quick and easy, and I really love the way it came out. So I have that, and then on top of that I just have some pretty lace and a little doily, and then another one of those blings I've been hoarding. And then I also have a little birdie, and that's also from the Angelic collection, so I cut him out and kind of stuck him in there. I have another really pretty soft flower behind the rose that I made. And then again, just lots of tassels and stuff, because I really love the way that looks. And then this little applique, like almost like a leaf. And then okay. This last pocket here is the same paper as the first pocket, which is just the pretty rose buds. And then I did the same with the little flatback pearls and the lace on top of that. Over here, I just have probably like 5 different layers of doilies. And these I just got at the secondhand store. So I just layered lots of doilies. Again, I did the same thing with the pearls. I just love the way that looks. It's so vintage. And I have a little heart button and some more of those little snowflakes. I have like these little almost like resin or plastic ones, and then I have these which were just from a spray from the craft store. And then right here, these little tickets, those are also part of the paper collection. So I printed those up and I scrumpled them up, if that's a word, scrumple. I scrunched them up. And you know, I wanted them to look kind of tattered and old, and I just put those, glued those on here. And the same thing with this music note sheet. I kind of crumpled it up too. And it's just a music note sheet for Oh Christmas Tree. So I thought that was really sweet. So I put that there. And you guys, I also wanted to mention that these aren't just the cutouts here. Let me show you some of the other cutouts from the collection. I printed them up for you so you can kind of take a peek. So here's one of the pages of the cutouts. It's got wings, little angel wings, and a Christmas tree, and little cherubs. And then this one right here, this one is like the postcards that I showed you. So I showed you this one, this one, this one, this one, and I think that's it. So I printed up just a couple of them. And at this point, my printer was not very good. This is not part of her collection, you guys. I tried printing up like twice, and for some reason, I think my yellow is running out, and so it's doing that line thing. But in, you know, of course that's not going to happen with yours. And then this one right here, I used some of these cutouts too. I used this little one, and I'll show you that in a little bit. But yeah, these are really, really awesome, really easy to fussy cut. And then there's 2 more down here. So here's the little tickets and the music note page. Here's one of the butterflies that I use, and the little songbird and the cherub. Oh, and I also use this little angel here. So I use a lot from that page. Really, really pretty. And then there's this one here. Again, really awesome little cutouts, and very easy to fussy cut. So I have those there. And then even for the paper, you guys, the collection, I only use like some of the paper. There are still so many. I'll give you another little sample. There's this one. And it's so pretty because you can see like a little Christmas tree in the paper. A little cherub sticking out. And they all like match so beautifully together. So this one is the one I used. And then there's these two. I used this page. I cut it out, and I'll show you afterwards, but I just wanted this part right here. It's so awesome because there's these two little fairies right here, and there's these two wreaths, and it says A Bright Christmas, but it's also like a to and from. So I really like the way that was. I'll show you. I put it on the back of my project. And this is the other page to this one that matches it. So this was for my first pocket and my third pocket. But you see there's all different kinds, you guys. I only used a couple of them. This blue is so amazing. It's magentic. It's like just so beautiful. I love this one. I definitely want to make a Christmas card out of it. I just haven't yet, but I love how beautiful that blue is. And then there's just coordinating solid paper right here. And it almost looks like fabric, so it was kind of cool. That actually is the inspiration I had is I saw this paper and it looked like fabric, and then that just got my wheels turning to printing it on fabric instead, and I just thought that was really cool. So those are the paper collections. Okay, let's get back to my project real quick here. So lots of doilies, lots of layering, some of the really pretty cutouts from the paper. This was just a fold flower that I made out of fabric. Really shabbed it up with lots of little strands of fabrics and stuff like that. And I layered it with a little doily and another bling. I have these really pretty beaded sprays coming out the side and another doily behind it. More of the like the tattered fabrics and really pretty laces. A lot of these cotton ones I actually also got from a Natasha. Thank you, Natasha. Back in the springtime with my Fairy Day Challenge. So I really like the way they look on here. And then over here is just some more of the pretty snowflakes here and there. I have some more lace just going around the pocket just for lots of layers. I have this really beautiful applique that I bought a few months ago. I just love those. They're so beautiful. Little wedding applique. And then on the bottom here, I just have this really pretty like scalloped. It looks like lace, but it was actually like a tablecloth that I got at the secondhand store, and I just cut off that. But see how it like goes up, loops over, and goes back down. Really, really pretty. So when it hangs, it just looks so beautiful. You see? So that's what the bottom looks like. And then the tassels kind of hang down. So that's that. And then, like I said, on the bottom, or on the back, I cut out that page, and I printed up on fabric. And I just wanted the to and from, because this is going to be a gift. It really doesn't match my my Christmas decor. Mine's more of like a country Christmas. So there's just that paper that I was showing you, and you can just write right here to and from. I'll just get a fabric marker and write it. And I really like the way that is. So, I mean, the back, nobody really looks at it, but it's really nice, you know, so they can remember who gave it to them. And so that's pretty much it for my project, you guys. Maybe if I can hang it up so you can see. Hold on. Let me hang it up. Okay, guys, so let me get a back view. I just have like this in between the doorway kind of section here that's bright enough to show up on the camera nicely. It's really overcast today. So see how it hangs up here? So this is the dowel rod, and it just hangs by some lace. And then those are the three different pockets. But see how big it is, you guys? But it looks so beautiful on like a big wall. Obviously not this one, because it would be hidden by the doorway. But so that's what it looks like hung up. And if you guys have any questions, please leave a comment below. And I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. And don't forget to check out Louisa's kits. She's got a ton of different ones. Not only does she have the Angelic Christmas, but she's got a bunch of other ones too. So definitely check it out. I left the link down below for you. So. And in the meantime, I hope you guys have a great week. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.